the radioactive nuclei in our environment. And then you see also bended particles, tracks. So these can be either muons or electrons, and tiny curly tracks, they are most of them are electrons.
So what sort of magnetic field is there?
There's no magnetic field.
No magnetic field?
No. You see, if you see bended tracks or deflections, then this is really an interaction between the incoming particle and atoms of the vapor. Okay, so they can communicate, because the incoming particle carries electric charge. And then, if it comes too close to an atom, then it might interact with the electrons in the shell around the nucleus of the atom, and then they interact because they both speak the same language. They both carry electric charge.
Right.
And then they...
So there's no persistent curvature then?
No. Yes.
It looks. It gives the impression that there
is. Yeah, it gives the impression, but there's no magnetic field. From time to time you also see the long, thin tracks, and you see like two of them, like a V shape. So this would be the decay of an incoming particle into something else, and into something else, even else, which is not visible.
Right. That's more rare.
So
yeah.
Whenever you see like kinks, like these Vs, they are other particles has been produced which you cannot see with this detector. And for example, neutrino.
And this is entirely ambient radiation, is it?
Yes.
It's quite sensitive, isn't it?
Yeah. And so there's a lot of activity around
it. And the
bolt.
The bolt.
The thick lines.
The thick ones, the thick ones. Yes. These are alpha particles. Helium.
I noticed there was one thick one I saw that was about, well, it was over 10 centimeters long, so it was longer than the others.
Yes.
Would that be just higher energy? Or?
There's only an average in the length.
Oh, right.
You know? Sometimes they travel longer.
Yeah.
Sometimes they don't.
So it's a relatively long one, yeah, but not quite as long.
Yeah, it also depends on the energy of the particle. So.
Mm-hmm.